Okay, then we're going to measure our prospective short circuit current and our prospective earth fault current in installation, which is done at the origin of the installation itself. Unlike our fault loop impedance, which is done at the furthest point of a radial circuit, this is done at our shortest possible part of the circuit, and we will be doing a test between line and neutral and line and earth within our consumer unit. The recording of the highest value on our test paperwork. We'll do our short circuit test first. It requires me to probe on, first of all, on the neutral, and the second one onto the line. Our instrument reads, first of all, voltage, and then goes through the test. We have a current of 364 amps for this one. We pull off the line conductor first and then off the neutral. Our next test will be between our line and earth for our prospective earth fault current. First of all, we go onto the earth bar, second onto the line bar. This reading is 423 amps for us. We are trying to confirm that the incoming device, which has a braking capacity of 33K, is able to withstand the current, with only being at just over 400 it can. And our devices within the consumer unit, which on these are rated at 10KA or 10,000 amps, again, can withstand a fault within the distribution board. Clear the fault and then be reset. Clear the fault and be replaced.
Please note that circuit breakers rated at 6KA or 6,000 amps can withstand fault currents up to 6,000 amps and be reset. Circuit breakers of 10KA, 10,000 amps, can withstand faults up to 10,000 amps, but can only be reset where the fault current level doesn't rise above 7,500 amps. Please note the on-site guide or the regulations for further information.